One morning in May, Bud woke me. "Hurry up," he said. "You're going to be late for school." "Go away," I murmured. But he pulled off my blanket and shook me. "You're really going to be late for school." I looked at my clock radio. 8:10. How come my arm didn't go off? I wondered as I jumped out of bed. I raced into the bathroom, splashed cold water on my face, threw on some clothes and headed downstairs. It was quiet in the kitchen. "Where is everyone?" I asked. "Ha ha," Fox sang, jumping up and down. "Ha ha ha, it's Saturday. I really hurt you, didn't I?" "You reader," but he was out the back door and running before I could set my hands on him. I crawled back upstairs and got into bed. "I'm going to kill that kid," I told myself. "I'm going to tear him to little pieces. I'm going to." I tossed and turned, but it was no use. I couldn't get back to sleep. I heard to see Beverly. I got up and walked down the hall to her room. She was sitting up in her sleep, filling out toys one at a time. She stood up when she saw me and held out of arms. I lifted her out of her sleep. "Yuck," I said. "You're smelly." I set her down on her table and changed her deeper. "Yuck," I said again. The worst thing about babies is diapers. I cleaned her up and dumped plenty of baby powder on her face side. "Yuck," Tootsie said. "That's right," I told her. "Yuck," I cried. Her down to the kitchen, put her in her high chair, and gave her a bowl of dry, clear to never. But stick in the back door as soon as he saw me. He took off again, but this time I chased him. When I caught him, I turned him upside down, tossed him over my shoulder, and carried him back to the house. "I screamed," he said. "You do, and you're dead," I told him. "If you hurt me, I'll tell," he said. "Go ahead and tell." I kicked open kitchen door, went to see so much upside down. She clapped her hands and looked by default face and turned dark red. "Put me down. Put me down," Fox cried. "Never," I said. "It was just a joke," he whined. "Can't you even take a joke? Some joke." Fox kicked and hurt. "Put me down," say please. I told him, "Please." "Please what?" I asked. "Please put me down. Say you'll never wake me up on the Saturday morning again." "I'll never wake you up on the Saturday morning again. Or a Sunday," I added. "Or a Sunday," he repeated. "Or a holiday," I said. "Or a holiday." Tell me how sorry you are that you did it today. I said, I'm sorry. How sorry? Very sorry. Very, very sorry. I asked, yes, very, very, very sorry. I stood him up and watched as a bird ran it from his face and his color changing from bright purple to flesh. Ha ha, he said, whirling away from me. I had my fingers crossed behind it, my back the whole time. So ha ha ha, none of what I just said is true. He dashed out the back door again. I shook my head. Yuck, Tootsie said. And then she took her bower of dry collar to the floor. How come you're up so early, Peter? Mom asked an hour later as she put her rope around her and yawned. It's a long story, I said. Well, it's contrary, it's a beautiful day. No point in washing it. She poured a cup of milk for Tootsie. Where's Fuzzy? Outside with Totter, I said. He's such an early bird, Mom said. I early bird case the worm.